Hey guys, I hope everybody's doing really good. I'm feeling better, so I'm going to do a video I've been wanting to do for a couple weeks now. And the knife is right in here. And there was like three different inspirations to buy this. Of course, I seen it first on my illegitimate brother Donovan 2's channel. And my illegitimate son, Jesse McJames' channel. But then when I found out it was made in Michigan, that's when it was a must-have. So I believe this pouch / sheath is original. You can see these old rivets. However, I got some paperwork that says these were OD green leather, and this looks black, but that could just be from age, because if this was truly made in early 1940s for World War II, then it might go black. I don't know. You leather workers can tell me about that, but it looks original, although I don't know if this is supposed to be some kind of camel snap or something, or if someone just made it by hand, because this is a C-1 Army Navy pilot survival vest knife, and it went into a vest, and I'll show you the picture here. These pictures I'm going to put at the end of the video. But this is pretty cool. You can see him pointing to the C1 here. Point to the C1 knife. And there's the C1 vest. Vest type emergency kit. Goggles. All kinds of stuff that fit in that vest. Gloves. Pretty cool hat. I don't know if that was in the vest. But I'll put these pictures on. And all this information came to me from Jesse McJames, because I was flying blind on this, and he did the homework. So anyway, let's take a look at it really quick. And I got some decorations up here. Thanks again, Kale, for the 33 and the dog head scale. And here I want to do a video and talk about this knife, which is pretty awesome. I don't want to ruin this snap. Now this knife is very sharp. You'll see a bloody band-aid, and that happened last night when I just bumped into the blade. And what's cool about this one is it's blued. And somewhere here in the notes, blades were coated with black oxide, but have some that look blued. That's this Don Lemon guy has. Adopted in 1943 for the Air Force, the C-1 emergency vest was referred to a knife folding hunting. The Navy version made with added bail and pouch by Colonial. So this one was made in Michigan. It doesn't have the bail, but it has the pouch, which is kind of odd. And if you look at this picture, I think, is from United Tool, but I don't see a pouch anywhere there. But let's forget about the pouch. Let's go back to this really quick. Bail was made by Colonial. Only two people had the contract for this, two manufacturers, Colonial and United Tool. 6 inches, 15 and 5/8 open, coated blade. Manufacturer is Colonial Cutlery Company. The other is United, spelled wrong, Machine Tool Company. I have found that the Colonial knives are the most common. But also in this paperwork, it says that United Machine Tool out of Grand Rapids, Michigan, was the first to make them. C1 survival knife. Made by United, Grand Rapids, the other maker, Colonial, in Providence. And there also was an unmarked version. And they couldn't remember which one it was. But over here in the other part of the paperwork was, here's what the counterfeiters were doing. They were issued to Navy flyers. The Grand Rapids company had the original contract. Later, a contract for the same knife was given to Colonial. At some point, several knives were sent back to Grand Rapids because they were not up to spec. They were all sent back to the Navy with a note, "We didn't make this crap." So, kind of sounds like Chuck Buck right there. What else can we show on this? There's an old ad that I'm thinking the one I have might be. There was 60,000 of these made for the military. But if you look here, from 46, after World War II, they had a whole bunch in stock. And they sold them as hunters, farmers, sportsmen, scouts, men. Here's a He-Man's knife. So they marketed it as a hunting knife. So I think that's what I got here. They might have added the belt pouch, because if it was a vest knife, I don't think they would have had the belt slots in there. Back in 2002, they were 45 to 55. On average, they go for 150. I was able to pick this up for, the guy wanted 140. I told him I'd give him 100. And he said, "How about 110? I said, "That sounds good to me." Also, the saw, 16% tungsten steel. Can't talk, it's early in the morning, as you can see. Although I've been up for about 3 hours. Still haven't woke up fully. And here's, OD green canvas pouch that fit in a pocket in the vest. Army and Navy Corps. But anyway, 16% tungsten steel, which caused a lot of them to break. Although the teeth, it was great to keep the teeth nice and sharp on the saw. They were very brittle. And at the time, the War Department had issued a ban on using tungsten steel with more than 6.75 for any weapons, but the giant jackknife had the life-saving role, so there was a cutout for it. But I'll put all this stuff at the end of the, let's see what else, maybe there's something else here, and we'll take a look at the knife, because it's cool. I mean, really cool. And made in Michigan, that completes the, what would it be, quadruple or quintuplet. Got Marbles, Bark River, Olson, and United. But I also picked up, when Lee Olson Jr. moved into the factory to build his hunting knives, the first knife company of that factory back in the 1800s was Hudson Knife Company. This was made in the late 1800s. They call it a paring knife, but it's big enough to be a steak knife. This is one that has the bluing. You can see all the bluing is still on it. Listen to that baby lock up. And here the liner lock goes all the way to the back of the tang. That'll focus in. So you gotta give it a significant push to get it closed again. And the thing is, there's so much tension on there. It has a half stop, 90 degree here. But it's not gonna flop in because this is holding it. So you got to kind of push it down. Then your tungsten steel saw, which is in really good condition. Doesn't even look like it's really been used. Well, one thing I got to show you on this, I don't know, and again, this here is getting in the way from keeping it closing, so it's kind of a manual return on it, but it does lock up. There's a little top to bottom jiggle, you can hear that. And United, Grand Rapids, Michigan. A little bit sharpened out, but they definitely put a good edge on it because some receipt paper here. Not bad for a big old knife. And I'm telling you guys, I just bumped it. I was playing with the saw. And I didn't do nothing to it. Didn't strop it. It's as is, so it's pretty sharp. But is that cool or what? And somewhere in the notes, after these fell out of favor, that's when the fixed blades came in. And I have one of them Pilot survival knives. I think everybody's got one. I know Boston's got one. Jesse's got one. Donovan's got a few. Big J. So, but 5-inch blade, 6-inch handle. And what was it, 13 something overall? Can't be 13. 10. Why does it say 15 5/8 opened? That's not right. It's not right at all. And as you can see, it's a little over 10 inches. So it's a misprint. And by the way, you guys, take this all for a grain of salt because I've got burned on these chat threads, like on Blade forums. I'm not sure where Jesse got this. Classic military fighting knives. So it's a good start, good opinion for you to do research further. That's pretty cool. Look at all those there. But I really like this old ad from Field and Stream. So anyway, we're 14 minutes in. My voice is sounding good and I got lots to do. And I really like this. Michigan made. There goes the light. So I'll leave you with this picture here. Until next time, my friends, take care. Peace. Bye-bye.